Hi, let's learn how to boost your FPS in Unity with a simple optimization technique called draw call batching. It's very easy, and today we're going to look at what it is, how we can do it, and common mistakes that a lot of developers fall into. We'll also be looking into how we can use the frame debugger, which is going to be really cool. Welcome to 100 Tips in Unity, and this is episode 8. So, what is batching? Now, imagine your CPU is a delivery truck and you are the GPU. And let's say you have ordered an item online, or in computer words, this is going to be the object that needs to be rendered. Okay. Now, normally, if you have an object to be rendered, the CPU takes care of it and tells the GPU that, hey, you have an object to be rendered. This process of the CPU telling the GPU what to do is called a draw call. Okay. Now, if there are multiple objects that needs to be rendered, let's say you have 1,000 items to be rendered. Because of the way computers work, it goes and renders each object back and forth, and it goes back and forth 1,000 different times. This is the problem with, you know, not doing batching. And what batching does is it essentially takes a lot of objects and puts them in one giant box. Okay. And you are saving a lot of delivery time. Okay. This is important to understand what is happening here. There is no change. 1,000 items are being received to the GPU, but they're being pushed in as one giant box. What is the downside of this thing? It is one huge box. So this means more memory and there is unpacking time. Okay. It needs time to separate things out, logically speaking, but this is super fast. So we can just ignore this thing, but it takes more memory. So that is the downside. But memory is a lot more cheaper and it is really, really not that big of a deal. So batching is always a win. And we're going to learn how we can do it in Unity right now. Okay, we should keep a note that only mesh renderers, trail renderers, line renderers, particle systems, and sprite renderers are supported for draw call batching. Meaning other renderer types like skinned mesh renderers are not supported. Over in this project, I have 100 cubes all sharing the same material. And I have aligned the camera such that you get all of the objects in the game view. If you click on stats, you can see already that there are 368 batches, meaning 368 draw calls. And it is insane because there are only 100 cubes. There are even more number of batches than the number of objects in your game. So you need to be conscious of this. We are going to tone this number down and we're going to optimize the heck out of this thing. Let's start. There are three different types of batching: static, dynamic, and SRP batching. First, let's look at static batching and how we can do it. To enable static batching, we go to Edit, Project Settings, Player, and then go to Other Settings, and you have static batching. And it should be enabled by default. Now, all you gotta do is to select all of the objects that do not move. Okay, so you're essentially batching objects or putting all of your meshes into one giant box and then sending it to the GPU. So you need to select all of your objects that do not move, and then you should not mark them static. This is where a lot of tutorials are just easy. Instead, you should click on this drop down here and then choose batching static. This is because you will have finer control over what your static objects are doing. Okay, you don't want to just blindly choose static. This is where a lot of tutorials get it wrong, because your game could have other things like global illumination, navigation, and you may have occlusion culling, which would really want you to separate things into different occluder statics and occludee static. So make sure to go in and click on this drop down and make sure to check batching static. That's all you need to do. And there we go. It's done. Now, if you go to the game and click on stats, there won't be any difference. But if you play the game, you can see the number of batches are now turned to 8, and you have saved 360 batches, which is great. To confirm this, you can go to Window, Analysis, Profiler, make sure to play the game, select a frame to pause the execution, and then head over to Rendering. Here you can see static batching, and it has batched 365 draw calls for 100 objects, which is insane. Now with static batching enabled, we can go to the Frame Debugger by going to Window, Analysis, Frame Debugger, and play the game. Once you play the game, you can click on this Enable. This is going to automatically pause the game, and it is going to show you how many draw calls there are in this current frame. And because we have static batching enabled, we only have 13 draw calls here. And if you go to game view, you can see things being rendered like this. You can see shadows also cast an additional draw call. If you go to drawing, you can see the entire frame. And you can see that there is only one static batch that is completely being rendered here. If I have static batching disabled and then open the Frame Debugger, play the game, and then enable it, you can see that there are 373 draw calls. If I go to drawing, this is really, really cool. I can open up, drawing contains 270 draw calls, and you can see that shadows are really big thing. And then there are 100 different objects. So there are 166 shadows, shadow maps or whatever, and you have 100 different objects. So shadows play a big deal. Now you can go over this and you can actually sequentially see how your frame is rendered. And it is going like this. So this is really, really cool, right? You can see what each frame is doing. That is really, really cool. I just wanted to show you this. This has nothing to do with the video. And you can see how your final output is being created with the help of Frame Debugger. And it's used to analyze how a frame is being created. And everything is working. Now, what if all of these objects are not static? Meaning they don't have any form of batching static enabled. They could be moving objects or they could not be moving objects. They are just not marked batching static. In this case, we can use something called dynamic batching. And this is a big thing. Dynamic batching occurs for meshes with less than 300 vertices. This cube is a perfect example because it has only, 8 vertices. If you have less than 300 vertices, things like bullets, projectiles, those are moving objects that you can batch. Dynamic batching is available in both default rendering pipelines and URP. But in URP, I do not recommend using it, because there is something else called SRP batching, which we'll talk about later in the video. If you are in the default rendering pipeline, and if you have a lot of moving small objects, you can batch them together. In order to do that, we go to Edit, Project Settings, Player, Other Settings, and make sure to mark Dynamic Batching. That is it. That is all you need to do. This is universal. You don't need to do anything else. And if you go to game immediately, you can see immediate effect. You only have 8 batches. In order to confirm that this is indeed dynamic batching, we can go to Window, Analysis, Profiler, or press Ctrl 7, and then play the game for a bit, and then pause the execution somewhere. You can go to Rendering, and here you can see dynamic batching has batched 365 draw calls. This is great. This is because each one of these meshes have less than 300 vertices, okay? It will not work on higher poly count meshes, okay? But this comes at a cost. As we discussed earlier, you would need more memory, you would need more CPU calculation as well. So if your game contains a lot of moving smaller objects, then it is okay. And you can also look at the Frame Debugger and you can see that you have a draw dynamic batch, meaning all dynamic objects are batched into a single thing. Okay, now we are currently in a URP project and we have the same 100 cubes. You can see there are 403 batches. If I play the game, you can see no change. Why is that? But FPS is okay. This could be confusing a little bit, but we can go to Window, Analysis, Frame Debugger, and then play the game and click on enable, but you can see that there are only 17 raw calls. And you can go to each thing and you can see everything is rendered together. So if you're using URP, you shouldn't rely on this stats window. This is not that updated because this uses something called set pass calls, which is not as updated as the final thing, because this thing is done in the post while this is not done in the post. Okay, so please do understand that this is why you should never rely completely on statistics. You should use profiler, frame debuggers and things like that. But the great thing about URP and SRP batching is that they are enabled by default and you don't have to do any damn thing, which is great. But I want you to understand what is happening here. This is important. Now, where is SRP batching in a URP project? You can enable and disable SRP batching. To do that, you have to select the universal render pipeline asset. And if you look at this asset, it won't be there because by default, it is hidden. You need to enable some things in order to enable or disable it. And to do that, we go to Edit, Preferences, and then go to Graphics. And here you have this option called Properties. And by default, advanced properties are all hidden. You need to set it to all visible. And now you can see that you have the option to enable or disable SRP batching and dynamic batching, which is great. So you can disable SRP batching if you want to. And now if you go to the frame debugger, disable this, you can see there are a bunch of draw calls without SRP batching. If you re-enable it and then go back to the frame debugger, you can see there are only 17 batches right now. So everything works automatically and you can just leave that setting there. Dynamic batching might be better in this case because all of these are lower poly meshes. But SRP batcher will always be better in the long run, especially as your game gets huge. You can use materials of same shaders to have fewer draw calls, which is good. So this is actually hidden from us. So I have to dig around Unity docs a lot in order to find out where it was. But hey, here it is. You can disable it here if you don't want SRP batching. Now you might be wondering, this is higher than the previous ones, but This is insane, okay, what URP has been able to pull off. What this does is it doesn't really bother about materials, okay? Instead, it looks at shaders. So any object, as long as they're using the same shader, will be rendered together in a single batch, which is crazy. It's great. So if you have different types of shaders, then different draw calls will be made. But essentially, you can use the same shader, but have different materials and everything will be put into a single batch, which is crazy to think about. If you want to learn more about SRP batching, I'll leave a link below to a blog post written by Arnaud Carré from Unity. And this is a great blog post to read. I'll leave the link in the description if you want to go in depth into it. And there we go. That's how you do batching. Now let's cover some basic rules and things that you have to look out for. It could be common mistakes as well while you are performing batching. Okay, a lot of people get this wrong. This is how you test things out. Firstly, you need to make sure that all of the objects that needs to be matched are sharing the same material. In this case, all of these are sharing the same material. If you are using URP, then make sure that they have the same shader. This is how SRP batching works. Okay. They could use different materials and it does not matter. But in the default rendering pipeline, you need to use the same material, okay? This means if you have two materials that are similar in nature, but their textures are different, you can then combine their textures inside Photoshop and then use the same material. This is going to save a ton of performance, okay? And as you can see, with frame debugging, every single object counts, because it adds up every single frame. Secondly, this is important, all batched objects should have uniform scaling. If it doesn't have uniform scaling, it considers it as a separate batch. This is really important and people might not consider that even scaling matters. If you have any form of variation in the scale, it is a separate batch. Okay, that's it. That's how things work. You need to make sure that they are all uniform and they are all equal. So another additional fact about static batching is that each static batch can contain only up to 64,000 vertices. Each cube here contains 8 and there are 100 cubes, which would mean there are 800 vertices in total, which is way less than 64,000, which is why they are all batched together. So this is an additional thing. Okay, this information is only available inside Unity docs, and I had to read a lot of it before researching this video. Also, again, this is mentioned before, but if you're using dynamic batching, it only takes in up to 300 vertices per object. If it is greater than that, then it is a separate batch, unless you are using SRP batching in URP or something like that. So I hope you understand that there are a lot of rules to this thing. The final thing is, when with static batching, do not just blindly check static. Again, I've mentioned this before. You will need things like occlusion culling, global illumination, and navigation. These things are things that you need in your game, and you will need finer control of these things if you are making a serious game, and you should get into the habit of setting these things individually. And I think this is a great start if you haven't already. So make sure that if you are static batching, check batching static instead of this entire thing. It is going to, you're going to learn a lot of finer control of how these static things work. Let me know if you need a video on just these things, what it does, how you can have finer control with these things, and yeah, things like that. So I hope this video was useful, and I hope you learned something today. Okay, that's it. That's it for this video, and I'm glad. And this took a while. Let me know if you would like a dedicated video on Frame Debugger or things like that, just to get it out of the way as a separate video. Or if you have any suggestions for tips in this playlist, please do let me know. I will see you in the next one. Take care. Peace.